Hi, welcome to Lachlan Likes a Thing, a show where I take a thing and see whether or not I like it. Now, the thing we're looking at in this video is the new Microsoft Type Cover 2 for Surface and Surface Pro tablets. In this video, I'm going to show you some detailed comparisons between the new Type Cover 2 and the original Type Cover 1. I'm going to show you my performance on some typing tests on the new Type Cover 2 versus the old Type Cover. And I'm also going to give you my opinion on whether to get the new Type Cover 2 or the Touch Cover 2 if you're buying a new Surface tablet, or if you already have an original Type Cover, whether it's worth the upgrade to the new Type Cover 2. Now, I've already uploaded my detailed review of the Touch Cover 2, so if you're looking for that, just head over to the link in the description of this video, and please click the like button if you found this review helpful. Now, this is the original Surface Type Cover, and I've always preferred the Type Cover over the Touch Cover because I'm much more accurate with typing on the tactile keyboard of the Type Cover. Now, this is the Type Cover 2, and as you can see, it comes in this new kind of two-tone color scheme with the black keys and a lighter gray texture. It also now comes in pink, purple, or blue. And as you can see, on first appearances, it looks almost identical to the original Type Cover. But appearances can be deceiving because the Type Cover 2 has lots of little changes over the Type Cover 1, which I think make it a huge improvement over the Type Cover 1. So let's take a closer look. The first big change is that the Type Cover 2 now comes with a backlit keyboard. You toggle between three brightness settings by pressing the F1 and F2 keys. These replace the volume up and volume down buttons on the Type Cover 1, though this isn't a big loss because the Surface has volume buttons on the side. Microsoft reduced the key travel of the Type Cover 2, which means that each key travels down less with each keystroke. We'll get into what that means for typing performance later in the video, but the reduced key travel does mean that the Type Cover 2 is a little less noisy to type on and each keystroke takes a little less effort. However, the keyboard feels a little mushier as a result. Microsoft made the Type Cover 2 a lot more rigid than the original Type Cover, and this is an improvement that's immediately obvious when using the Type Cover 2 on an uneven surface, like your lap. This improvement is especially great when combined with the improved kickstand design of the Surface 2 and Surface Pro 2. The increased rigidity did come with some compromise. The Type Cover 2 is now about 50 grams heavier than the Type Cover 1. This makes the total weight of a Surface Pro 2 with a Type Cover 2 about 100 grams heavier than something like an 11-inch MacBook Air. The Type Cover 2 is now thinner than the original Type Cover 1, but not by much. Microsoft claimed that the Type Cover 2 is now almost as thin as the original Touch Cover 1, and depending on how you define almost, I would consider that a bit of a stretch. However, because the keyboard is now a lot deeper inside the body of the Type Cover 2, the edges of the Type Cover now sit much more flush with the edges of the Surface. This helps the Type Cover 2 feel much more like a part of the tablet. The texture on the back of the Type Cover 2 has been changed from the felt-like material on the Type Cover 1 to something more plain. The new texture still feels nice, but I miss the charm of the old Type Cover. However, as long as the new material doesn't start coming apart like the old Type Cover fabric, I'm happy. Another nice change is that the palm rest and trackpad of the Type Cover 2 aren't the gummy black plastic found on the Type Cover 1. Instead, it's the same material used on the back of the new Type Cover, which feels nicer to the touch. One thing to note though is that the trackpad on the Type Cover 2 is touch sensitive and no longer a clickable button, and the trackpad no longer supports tap and hold to drag. I like the new Type Cover 2 trackpad, but still use the touchscreen and stylus more often. Like I found in my review of the Touch Cover 2, there's been an element removed from the folding part of the Type Cover 2 that seems to make the folding mechanism less rigid. I think the folding mechanism is less durable as a result. Now I'm going to show you my performance on some typing tests on the new Type Cover 2 versus the old Type Cover. This is not going to be a scientific test, it's just a free typing test I found over at 10fastfingers.com. It's not real world typing, but I'll try to give you my results averaged over 5 runs on the Type Cover and the Type Cover 2. Also, I'm going to be performing the typing test on my new Surface Pro 2. So on a side note, if you're interested in my review of that, just subscribe to my channel and you'll be notified when that's uploaded. Anyway, let's try typing. I've always thought typing on the old Type Cover 1 was quite decent, with a good clicky tactile feel. My standard keyboard is the really nice DAS keyboard, which is based on an IBM mechanical design, and I've never felt the Type Cover 1 was dramatically worse in comparison. Over 5 runs, I averaged 97 words per minute, which I think is pretty good for a laptop keyboard. On the new Type Cover 2, I feel like the reduced key travel results in more of a blunt feel to keystrokes, which is a little less satisfying. On the other hand, I feel like my fingers have to move less of a distance for each keystroke, and as a result, I can type slightly faster. It seems a bit like a question of preference which Type Cover you prefer typing on. Over 5 runs, I averaged 102 words per minute,
which is only a little faster than on the Type Cover 1, and probably within a margin of error.
So here's my opinion. If you're trying to decide between the Type Cover 2 and the Touch Cover 2, and if you do any sort of typing at all, I recommend you should go for the Type Cover 2. I found that I can basically type almost twice as fast on the Type Cover 2 than I can on the Touch Cover 2. There's a lot of nice things about the Touch Cover 2. I mean, it's thinner, it's lighter, it's spill-proof, and if you're interested, you can check out the link in the description for my Touch Cover 2 review. But overall, just in terms of typing accuracy, I so much more prefer the Type Cover 2. Now, if you already own an original Type Cover 1 and you're wondering if it's worth upgrading to the Type Cover 2, one thing to keep in mind is that people are still buying the original Type Cover 1s on eBay, and I've seen used Type Cover 1s go for about $60 to $80 on eBay. Now, considering that I bought my Type Cover 2 in retail for about $120, that means the total cost of the upgrade would work out to be about $60 to $80. With that in mind, here's how I would decide if it's worth the upgrade to the Type Cover 2. Now, if you use your Type Cover 1 at the moment, basically always on a table, on a flat surface, in a well-lit environment, you're not gonna get much more out of the new Type Cover 2. The backlight's not gonna really matter to you, the extra rigidity doesn't really come into play when you're working on a flat desk, and the new Type Cover 2 is actually slightly heavier. So, you know, it's not overall gonna be an improvement. Now, if you're like me and you use your Surface Pro everywhere, so you use it on your lap or just in different environments, maybe they're not well lit, basically the new Type Cover 2 is an across the board improvement. You get a much better typing performance when you're using it on an uneven surface. The backlight is incredibly useful. The extra rigidity and the way it sits flush with the surface now is a huge improvement. So if that's the case, I do recommend it as an upgrade, or if you're gonna buy and you're trying to decide between the Type Cover or the Type Cover 2, go for the Type Cover 2. Anyway, click the like button if you found this review helpful, and if you want to see my review of the Surface Pro 2, subscribe to my channel and you'll be notified when that's uploaded. Thanks to everyone who's liked my other videos and subscribed to my channel. You can talk to me on Twitter at @LachlanLikesAThing or on Facebook at facebook.com/LachlanLikesAThing. I'm looking forward to your comments and enjoy the rest of your week.